confiscated videotapes of Bob and Lila on the Channel 3.
Yeah, I should give you guys a warning, so, you know.
Red, it's you.
Oh, it's me?
Yeah, so if you're gonna pass.
Thirty seconds.
Thank you. Tense up.
Tense up.
Get your mouth.
On the plan, Mission Crew, it was the plan to build a school warmer on the west side of the project that's slated to open on 10th Street West and after Old Fort is on the south. Oh, it's for 14,000 square feet. It may offer groceries to the developers on the building. It's just space for more.
Here we go.
Stand by.
Good show.
All right,
good show. It's Friday.
6, 5, 4, 3.
First on 3 tonight, world-renowned motivational guru Zig Ziglar is the keynote speaker at today's Business Outlook Conference. Good evening, I'm Lila Bleeker.
And I'm Bob Montague. The top story tonight is the 32nd Annual Board of Trade Conference held at the new fairgrounds.
Channel 3 caught up with Ziglar to hear his famous words of wisdom for the Antelope Valley.
It's a glimpse of your potential. Passion is born. Now, when passion is born, you can count on it. People of average ability can then do some great things. So we're going to look at how do you take where you are right now, look at developing that passion, and then I will share with them why what they already know qualifies them to do some incredible things if they recognize it, develop it, use it, and claim it.
Ziglar has been a motivational speaker for more than 3 decades. He says the best is yet to come.
And business has certainly been growing here in the Antelope Valley. The Board of Trade wants to continue attracting new business to the area. That was the subject of today's Business Outlook Conference. AV3's Asha Sondi has that story.
Corporations and community leaders gathered today at the annual Business Outlook Conference. The meeting's focus is to help bring business to the Antelope Valley. General Doug Pearson, a commander at Edwards Air Force Base, attended the conference.
We run one of the largest businesses in the Antelope Valley. My operating budget is just over $1 billion a year. And so we are a big business. And so it pays to stay in tune with what's going on around the community. So.
The Business Outlook Conference is a chance for all aspects of the community to come together, sit down at one table, and discuss the challenges and benefits of doing business in the Antelope Valley.
The Board of Trade does 2 things most people do not realize. One, it works with businesses and corporations and so on. But it is a bridge to the politicians. Because if the politicians are not involved, things don't happen in our world.
The meeting also focuses on factors that may affect business, such as environmental concerns and water issues.
We're talking about issues that we can fix. We're looking for people that can fix the issues that we can't fix. We're getting government involved. We're getting people talking so that solutions can come up.
Not only does it just affect the jobs that are on the base, but it affects our business economies because those people that live here shop and do their business here. So it's going to not just affect the base, but it's going to affect the entire Antelope Valley.
Organizers say success in the valley depends on bringing in new businesses. This is Asha Sondi reporting for AV3 News.
And this was the first time that the conference was held at the new fairgrounds, Poppy Pavilion.
Rain hit the Antelope Valley today. We had showers throughout the day in the high desert, along with chilly weather. The storm is making the roads slick, and drivers are advised to be careful and slow down. Meanwhile, rain moved throughout the Los Angeles area. Lightning hit a pole in West LA and knocked out power to several businesses.
Well, straight ahead, 2x2. Will Noah be needing his ark, or will that rain let up? We'll check in with Mitchell Chase on your AV 3-day forecast.
Plus, a Palmdale sheriff's deputy made a very special delivery today. We'll explain next.
Sorry, I didn't have that score. What happened?
That tease? I totally forgot that I wrote it, but like what it said. Hello? But Jennifer read it and said it was fine.
It's okay, great. I kind of like it mixed up a little bit.
Fun. No, but no, will Noah be needing his ark, or will the rain let up? Noah's ark? I don't think she caught it. She turned it in, and I totally didn't even.
It's great.
Oh, my goodness.
You mean that was like a joke from you or something?
Well, I just thought it was funny, but she said it was okay.
Well, it's Richard's ark. delivered.
Sir.
Were you there?
What time were you?
Coming back to Bob on one.
Morning.
Coming back.
Bob on six.
Bob on four.
We have six cameras.
Which way?
Inside.
Another speaker at today's Board of Trade Conference was the CEO of the California Building Association. I should say he is the CEO. He attended a party last night put on by the local developer, Greg Anderson.
Doing well here, and one of the reasons is you're still building what we like to call affordable housing, even though that's all in the eye of the beholder. But I was looking at some numbers coming down here, and for a single-family detached home, new home for sale, you're still in about $275,000 range. Los Angeles County in general is close to $500,000, and Orange County is $720,000.
Got some more advice for locals. Buy a home now while those interest rates are low.
Now to world and national news. The U.S. says American troops in Iraq can expect a long-term stay.
AV3's Asha Sondi has that story tonight in World Watch. Asha?
Thank you, Bob and Lila. Officials said American soldiers will be staying in Iraq even after power is turned over. Officials say the presence of American troops will be necessary to ensure a stable transition to democracy. Under international law, if the new Iraqi government decides it wants American forces to leave, U.S. officials say they would comply. The chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff said he could not say for certain how long troops will be needed in Iraq. And in other news, the Supreme Court agreed to hear a case that has been causing a lot of controversy. The government has detained hundreds of people they consider enemy combatants with suspected terrorist ties. The problem, however, is that for some, they have been in jail for 2 years and have not been allowed to speak with their attorneys at all. Critics claim such acts are unconstitutional and violate basic human rights. The government, however, maintains that enemy combatants do not receive traditional legal protections. And the FBI is still trying to sort out the details in a separate incident that forced a Moroccan airliner to land in Maine. The FBI said it was interviewing a passenger from Flight 201 named Zubair Ghass. Authorities said a passenger on that plane phoned a family member and made a statement about a bomb threat against the aircraft. Police say Ghass's wife filed a missing persons report when he disappeared from Chicago last weekend. The plane was diverted after Ghass phoned his family saying he was being kidnapped. A private investigator hired by Ghass's family told a radio station that Ghass said he had no choice and was doing this to save his family. The plane was carrying 82 passengers and 10 crew members. And that is all in World Watch for this Friday. Back to you.
Asha, thank you. Now to news around the state. In Los Angeles, a police officer was shot and killed while trying to serve a search warrant. A citywide tactical alert was issued while authorities look for the suspect. In the Southland, gas prices continue to rise for the seventh week in a row. The average price is $1.93. Officials say prices are increasing because of strong demand. In Sacramento, a state senator introduced a bill to ban teen drivers from using cell phones. The measure would affect drivers who are 16 and 17 years old. Lawmakers say they're inexperienced drivers and need better concentration behind the wheel. And that's California Headlines for Friday. Coming up, we'll tell you how Palmdale kids learned about the dangers of smoking.
That story when the news continues.
Yeah, there you go. Oh, you do that really well.
That'd be great. See you later. I used to smoke. Did you smoke?
Yeah, they do.
You want camera too close?
After I lived in England, so I came out here and I was smoking a little bit, but soon I stopped.
Holy moly.
Yeah, I know people say it. It's come up a couple of times when somebody said, yeah, Mitchell used to smoke. I just can't picture it.
Yeah, I think I knew you when you smoked.
I was smoking. I smoke. You smoke? I would leave, like right now, go outside, have a cigarette right before we came back. It's bad. It's really bad.
Okay, come back to Lila on one.
At the end.
Is that what they've stopped? One of your kids begging you guys to beg my dad? Please stop.
30 seconds.
He's gonna be like, oh man, it's too bad you won't see your kids graduation.
Oh, wow.
Boy, that's a great example for your kids. So I used to look out, like Russ looked out to see, is that they want to hear it? What am I gonna argue here?
Six, five, four, three.
This morning, Palmdale High School students were raising their adrenaline and at the same time raising money to help local cancer patients. AV3's Jennifer Perlman has the story.
Students at Palmdale High School were taking steps to fight cancer. They walked around the campus track for a walkathon called Laps for Lungs. The organizers of this event are trying to get the word out that it's not cool to smoke. Teens who walked in Laps for Lungs also collected money for the American Cancer Society.
I think personally it's really important that kids need to know the effects of drugs, alcohol, and tobacco use on your body, the importance of proper nutrition and physical activity as awareness and prevention of diseases in their future lives.
During the event, kids were asked to breathe through a straw and hold their nose while walking just for a minute so they could get a feel for what smoking does to your lungs.
Basically, don't smoke. It's really bad for your lungs. Basically, to breathe, it's like the breath of life. If you don't have breath, you can't really live.
Senior Victoria Aragon got students involved with an incentive. The class that raised the most money for the American Cancer Society would get a special prize.
I told them that it was for Laps for Lungs, it was for a good cause, and they were like, oh, okay, you know, that sounds nice. And at the end, I was like, and you get a pizza party. So if you get enough money, you raise enough money. And each class did good. They raised more than $94 every class. And now seven classes with 30 kids in each class.
In total, Palmdale High School students raised more than $550 for the AV chapter of the Cancer Society.
I think it's a really, really good idea for these kids to bring awareness to their campus and to the kids that they interact with every day. You know, this just shows a lot of leadership.
The money will go towards local programs to help cancer patients here in the Antelope Valley.
Without donations such as this and Relay for Life and Daffodil Days, we don't have the funds to offer the services to the people in our community. It is really needed, yes.
This mini walkathon was organized as a senior project.
And this was the second annual Laps for Lungs event. Good stuff.
Good for them. Good leadership qualities.
Good way to step into the weekend. Yeah. So we hope you all have a great weekend.
Have a good weekend. Good night, everybody.
Good night.
Be safe this weekend. We'll see you soon. Good night.
Clear. Lights go down. We got time to go. 20 seconds of it. I really want to hear. I just want to like throw like a tantrum. Just beat this stuff down.
We'll react.
All stuff
right, go ahead and do it. We'll just go, oh my gosh.
Wow. We all go different ways. We're all going different ways.
He's going crazy.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We are clear.
Good job, Lila.
Clear?
Good job, bitch.
We're clear.
You guys have a great weekend.
Good job, everybody. Good job, Fred.
Thank you, Mike. Good job. It wasn't for her, though. You'd never make it through her gas. $8 a gallon.
Thanks.
Are you serious?
Yeah, I'm serious.
Good job, Josh.
I was there last year.
I was going to fall asleep. I went to fall asleep at the end.
No, it feels real good.
It's really crazy.
Because it's hot.
Yeah, good job.
Yeah, for us,
yeah,
for us.